It's Kim Kesty back in the creative classroom, and I'm super happy to be with you today to film the project tutorial for Becca Feakin's Sweet Cardlets project kit. It is so adorable. The projects are adorable. The actual glimmer plates are adorable. We are going to have so much fun today. Let's check out the Sweet Cardlets glimmer plates first, because there's something really special about these guys. Hopefully you got your box, you've unboxed everything. Now these glimmer plates are really cool. It's kind of a different concept for Becca, I think. Each individual glimmer plate has everything you need to create your whole project. So if you take a look at this one, for example, just because, we've got the main focal point, the B, plus some little accessories. We've got the background plate for your card. We've got choice of two different sentiments. We've got the dies that match. Of course, you can look at the back, and here they all are. So absolutely everything you need, focal point, background, sentiment, everything's all in one package. So how cool is that? You could just take your one plate and off you go. This is going to be the first card we're going to start with, Graceful Swan. So same thing, focal point, sentiments, background. That's going to be all ready to go. And then our other card we're going to work on today is going to be the cute little lovely ladybug. And again, background, focal point, dies to match, and the little sentiments. So like I said, we're going to start with this one. Also in your kit, you have two brand new rolls of glimmer foil. You've got this opal. I'm going to teach you some really great tips and tricks on this guy. And then your classic gold, which is a never fail foil for sure. You've got your two postcards. So you've got your pretty pictures of your projects, plus all your supplies, instructions. And these supplies, of course, are pre-cut for you in your card kits, which I've already got my first one kind of taken apart here, but all your little fun supplies and your card kits. And then if you want to recreate it, then you've got your additional supply list here. So check, check, check. I'm going to set these aside and you can refer to them, of course, or you can just follow along with the video. That's super fun too. So for this first project, we're actually going to use both rolls of foil. And like I said, the Graceful Swan, so cute. I'm just going to pull apart the pieces that we're going to use. We're going to use the swan that has the matching die. So you've got two different swans in this little glimmer product. You've got a solid swan that's going to do a solid gold swan, and then you've got the outline. So today we're going to be using the outline on our project. And then our little sentiment is going to be the choice of gorgeous inside and out. So those are the products you're going to need for this first card project. Now glimmering is always fun. What you really want to do, first of all, is you want to grab your glimmer machine. I'm just going to bring it into the shot just a little bit here, because you always want to, mine's been heating up, so I'm actually going to turn it off. It's got a timer. If you ever wonder why your glimmer plate cools off, it's because it's got a self timer, which is cool for when you walk away accidentally. So I'm just turning mine back on. It's going to heat up. It's going to heat up pretty quick because it's already been on. And I'm going to wait for that green light to pop on. And when it does, I'm going to be ready for my very first project. So let me grab out my foil. So just trim your glimmer foil down to a square. This is probably 3x3 or so. And now you can see that my green light is on for my platform, which means it's all hot and ready to go. So I've got my swan. And then also from your kit, you want to grab, just so you have it handy, your little small piece of whipped cream cardstock. So you've got a large one back here. That's your card base. You know, don't cut into that guy. You just want your little plain piece. It's already trimmed to size for you. Now for my glimmering, I'm going to want to put the pretty gold down. You always put your pretty side down against the glimmer plate. And then I'm just going to add my little paper on top. And this is warm, but it's not like it's going to burn you if you barely touch it. Of course, caution, caution, always when using these hot tools, right? And then you're going to need your regular platinum die cutting machine, which I have mine off to the side. I'm going to pull it in just a second. So set the timer. I guess I could have done that a minute ago when the green light was on. Move this over just a little bit. I can have my platform ready, and here's my platinum six. You can use your platinum six or your larger platinum machine. Both of them work fine. Okay, now we can see our timer light is green, so we are ready to go. I like to take my platform, undock it out of the glimmer station, and move it to my platinum before I put the cover plates on. That's just me. Maybe that's not the way you glimmer, but seems to work good for me, and then maybe I won't, I can't drop it on my little platform or anything. Now I'm just going to slowly go through my platinum machine, and I'll let that plate and press my beautiful gold foil on my little swan. And then we just come back out the other side. And again, I like to redock this guy right away so it can start heating up again. And then we can see that we've got our kind of impression of our little swan. This is always the fun part, the reveal. And there we go. Ooh, it looks like he got kind of close to the top of my cardstock there. That's okay. We're going to die cut this guy out. So while my platform's heating, and my biggest tip for using the washi, or any repositionable tape, doesn't have to be washi, is when you add it to the die, just try not to like slap your tape right on top of your foiled project, right? Because the tape will lift off some of your pretty gold foiling. So you don't want to do that. And there we go. I'm going to take my platform off my die cutting machine there so I can get it ready for my next glimmer project. So we'll set aside our little swan. Now this next one is going to be using the opal foil, which like I told you is kind of fun. It's a little bit tricky because it is very clear. So let's take a look at that. Get this guy out of the box. So if you look at the opal foil, you can see as it's on its roll that it's got this beautiful opal, you know, pearlescent, really, really pretty look. But as you unroll it, you know, it becomes less obvious. It looks just clear. Oh, I guess some of our video lights picking that up. That's pretty cool. Iridescent type look. So the only big reminder I have for you, or the best reminder I have, is just treat it just like your regular foil. In the same way that this pretty gold foil is on top of the roll, you know, as you unroll it, it's the most special part is on the top. Same with this opal foil. The very special shine is on the top of your roll. So just a little memory clue, kind of help you figure that out. But let's take our little swan off. So we're going to put our background piece down. And this piece is a tiny bit taller than it is wide. It doesn't really matter which way you put it on there. The swirls just kind of all speak for themselves. But you're also going to grab this smaller piece of lavender cardstock. And you can see that it just pretty much just fits right on top of there. And this also is just to remind you, kind of a background piece for our swan. So it's going to be kind of a little bit hidden on our final card, but that's okay. It'll give us good practice. So reminder, like I'm keeping the pretty side up for my pretty opal foil. And then as I would always do, I flip this around face down. Like same like I would do with my gold, you know, just flip it face down. And that's going to give me the foiling that I want. I can push the timer now so it can be heating up. It's already warm for my last one, but timer can get going. And then I'll just put my cardstock right on top. Okay, the timer light is solid. Now I'll undock, again, put my shim and my spacer pad on, and off to the races. And this is going to be a really cool effect. This is definitely kind of a tone on tone. You might even call it a watermark effect. So when we peel this opal foil, you're just going to get a really pretty darkening of that cardstock. Isn't that pretty? So kind of spin it in my light here. You can see that it's just got that beautiful kind of opalescent, luminescent look. So gorgeous. So remember, we're doing the gorgeous inside and out sentiment. Of course, it's your card. You can switch sentiments if you want. Either one would be absolutely lovely. Now, our actual pretty amethyst cardstock that you've got in your kit, we purposely give you a little extra cardstock. So in case it's not straight, you can trim it up a little bit. Oh, wow, look at that. Pretty good. I'm going to have to trim it a little bit more narrow because I want it to be more narrow on my card. But now when you trim it, you can go ahead and do it, you know, if you want to do it wider than what we have on the card, it doesn't really matter. All right, so I like mine kind of skinny. You guys can play around and do yours. All right, so now I'm going to bring in some of my main pieces of my card kit back again, and then this is just kind of a quick and easy assembly part. I like to use a crease tool just to get it nice and sharp. And then you've got this pretty tin pail mat, but before you glue it on, we're going to do a little ribbon action. So you've got this pretty lavender ribbon in your kit. So we're going to tie this around the gray panel before we put it to your card. You should have plenty of ribbon here, probably some extra. It might be a little too long here. I'm gonna cut this a little bit shorter just for now. All right, so this guy's gonna go up with foam squares. You can adhere it straight down if you want. I even kind of put one over my ribbon. You see where I placed that? Kind of helps hold my ribbon in place, maybe keep it centered a little bit better. Put one on this side over here. Little extra ribbon trick there. You've got a pretty gold panel, and that's going to be a nice mat for your glimmer that you did for your background. And it's a pretty skinny little mat. That's what I sometimes call a eyeliner mat. And of course, this is going to be popped up also, because why not? This panel is actually a good idea to pop up because it's going to kind of float on top of this ribbon. Share all my little card making tips with you guys as we go along. All right, so now we've got this die cut, which, by the way, if you have not experimented with these die cuts, this is also from Becca Feakin's collection. These are her Pico Petite squares. We've pre-die cut this for you. If you already have this at home, then just count yourself lucky because it's absolutely beautiful die. Now we've got our little cute little swan. And then we're going to layer the swan kind of with the sentiment. So I'm also going to pop him up. Him or her, which is it? I'm not sure. I'm going to slice one of my little foam squares in half just to get a little piece popped up under his head. Maybe I say he because I feel like the male swans are like the prettier ones, right? You know what? I'm going to tuck it under. That works better. There we go. All right, fun. Okay, so we're pretty close. We've got a few little embellishments. I'm going to angle the ends of my ribbon, and I do that by folding the ribbon in half. And then I kind of slice in toward the center, toward the fold. And that gives me a cute little pointed end of my ribbon. Did you see that? Same thing over here. Fold your ribbon in half. This just makes it even. And then you're going to cut toward the fold. There's my little ribbon there. Now I have a couple options for adding my leaves. If you have a hot glue gun, you can do that. I've got glue dots, which are pretty strong, which are good glue dots. So I'm going to go ahead and add my two little gold leaves. These are also pre-die cut for you. I'm going to kind of tuck them in with my bow here. Or you could use wet glue if you had a little bit extra time to let it dry. And then you've got your little tin pail flower, which is, of course, coordinates with the background. It's on a piece of wire, so you're going to want to go ahead and cut that shorter. I've actually got our craft shears here from Fun Stamper's Journey. I don't like to cut wire with my good shears. I'm going to put two glue dots on this guy. One. Two. And then my cute little paper flower can kind of nestle right in between those leaves. It would also be super sweet to use one of Becca's dies and create your own flower. She's got all of her darling little Cinch and Go flowers. But check it out, guys. Card number one. So cute. Fluffy bow. Beautiful swan. Lovely Pico Petite. Got a little sentiment. And I actually like that it's a top folding card, too. So you can kind of, when your recipient gets it, they can kind of, you know, put it on display. Let's see if we can get our side view here. Our side view is not wanting to focus. There it goes. Yay. Look, how cute is that? So much fun. You guys did a fantastic job with project number one. I'm going to make sure my glimmer's heating up over here, and we'll be right back and work on project number two. And we're back for card number two. Got my glimmer machine all ready to go. Card number two, we're going to switch over to the new glimmer plate cardlet set here called Just Because. We'll be using these other pieces on our third card, but for now we'll need that. We'll need our gold foil. I'm going to tuck my postcard aside, but remember you've got your instructions there also. Card kit pieces. I think I'm going to start with glimmering that cute little bee. Put it on the platform and push the timer button. I'm going to wait for that light to turn green and then run it through my die cutting machine. Check out our darling little bee here. So cute and golden. Love her. Of course, I'll bring in the little matching die cut and do the same technique I showed you earlier with the swan. And she just pops out, so perfectly die cut. I'm going to repeat the glimmering with my sentiment. Better just because. Popping right off of there. Looks pretty straight. I'll probably trim the bottom just a little bit down, just a little bit. And then you want to keep the ends a little bit longer because we're going to actually fold it around our next card panel that we're going to glimmer. Now we're going to do the background. Let that platform heat up, and then we'll, I feel like saying, rinse and repeat. Go through your glimmering one more time. This time we're glimmering our pineapple smoothie panel. The reveal is always the fun part, right? The darling little kind of beehive for our little bee to play around with. All right, so we've got our bee and our background and all of our fun little pieces. There's a few more die cutting things I'm going to do, but before I do that, I'm going to bring in some of our gold silk. I just thought it would be fun to just kind of silk the background of this panel. And so gold silk is kind of a fun little enamel splatter type of product. It does have some really yummy gold enamel at the bottom, so you're going to want to shake that up a little bit. If you don't have gold silk, that's fine. Your card will be just darling even without it, but it does add just a fun little kind of extra layer of goodness. Maybe it looks like little droplets of honey, I don't know, but that is the gold silk. We've got pattern paper and a small little gold mat, so we can adhere those guys together. I thought the little bit of gingham was cute for the back here. I guess it's not really gingham, it is more like plaid. Tablecloth plaid, maybe. And then our card base, of course, you can fold in half. This panel, as we assemble your card, I did use foam squares and kind of pop this up. It's optional for you, but if you like that look. Now this panel, the silk doesn't take too long to dry. On this panel, before we start adding it to our card project, we actually want to wrap our sentiment around. Remember I said we're going to wrap it around that panel? I'm going to quickly trim mine just a smidge. And then you more or less kind of want to go right around the center of your little beehive you made here, honeycomb. And I'm going to add more foam squares, which will also help hold this in place. So I'm going to make sure it's right where I want it. We've got a little bit more die cutting to do for our accents. This card is coming together nicely. All right, so of course we're going to be adding our cute little bee, but before we do that and before I figure out where the placement is, I'm going to grab these two little tiny dies. Remember, I told you we're going to be using those. And then you've got a piece of mirror gold. I actually think mine is a little bit too big for when we actually went in and kitted them, but you'll have plenty. I'm going to want two solid dies. I'm going to layer them first. I'll do the little more tricky one first. It's not really tricky, but I'm going to layer these two because I want just some outline pieces of my little extra honeycomb piece. I'm going to do three just like this. And they're all just your normal die cutting sandwich. So of course, when you die cut these little outline pieces, you're also going to have the centers which fall out. So I think we'll use a couple of those also. Okay, so for these guys, you can just use a little bit of liquid glue if you want, whatever your choice of glue is here. And I'm just going to use these fun little mirror die cuts just to kind of enhance the original glimmer plate that we did. I'll just use two of these guys. And you can refer to the photo on your postcard if you kind of want to see how I place them, or you can place them in your own cute little spot. This is, I'm kind of tucking under the sentiment a little bit. That's fun. Solid pieces make it look, you know, like that's fun. The honeycomb is full of honey. You could also get really crazy if you wanted and pop these up with a little bit of foam tape, maybe something like that. Totally up to you. I just thought that would be a fun little extra layer. Okay, so one of our last little accents we're going to add is our bee. And then we've got a few little fashion gold dots we're going to use as the grand finale. Now I'm putting my little foam squares kind of an angle here, and I'm actually going to double up. So I'm going to put two foam squares just so she pops up a little bit more. And then you can kind of, you know, place her around wherever you want. I think she's going to kind of overlap my sentiment just a little bit, maybe a little more angle. There we go. So cute. Look at her just flying in. And then your little gold dots, you want to just sprinkle around. They can be overlapping your honeycomb, or maybe it depends on where your little silk fell. Just have fun with adding those to wherever you want. Okay, I'm going to stop at 5. I think 5 is enough. Okay, so now we've got our sweet little because card. Isn't that just sparkling gorgeous? I think the mirror even just elevates it just a little bit more. beautiful glimmer, cute little square card. And again, it's kind of the top fold, so it'll sit up super cute. So your recipient can put it on display. So cute. Maybe we'll leave this shot here for something kind of different. As you finish this card project, maybe you want to catch up a little bit. And we will be right back to work on card number 3. Now, before we start project number 3, which also uses the same glimmer plate that we just used, I want to share a little funny with you guys. I'm going to have Roy put a label on the video as we edit it. But do you guys notice anything different about this picture in my card? I used the Oh Honey sentiment on the original card on your instructions, and I used the Just Because on my card. But you know what? It doesn't even matter because both of them are super adorable, and I'll just switch my sentiment for the next card that we're going to do right now. But totally interchangeable, whichever way. This is when I wished we were live, had a live audience. You guys could give me a hard time, but that's pretty funny. So I'm going to set that card aside. We'll show all of them later. Now you just want to flip your postcard over. I'm going to do this card, which is a little bit hard to see in the postcard. So I'm hoping that as the video comes to life here, you'll get a little bit more detail out of it. Because we're doing some fun little watercolor action. So let me show you how that's going to work. So again, we're using the same glimmer plate. I've kind of got all the pieces out. This time we're going to add these two extra. This is an extra little die cut. So it's going to kind of pop up the wings of our sweet little bee. And we're going to add her little crown. And of course, I am switching my sentiment. But of course, you can go back and use the other one. Here's the Just Because I accidentally used. Oh my gosh, that's funny. So the kit that we're working with now has got this pretty peach card base. You've got some other pieces of cardstock, and the piece that we're going to start out with is the watercolor sheet. Now, again, you probably can't tell in the video, but it's a heavy-duty splash sheet, and it is a watercolor sheet. You'll be able to tell right away when you pick up yours from your kit. It's got a nice texture and a nice weight to it. We're going to start with that guy. We're also going to be using the opal foil again. That'll be fun. This is a really cool resist technique. Our product manager, Robin, came up with this technique, and I was just dying. I'm like, I want to use that on a video. So she said, go ahead, go for it. So that is going to be fun. So we're going to cut a piece of I'm calling it foil. It doesn't seem like it is foil, right? I mean, it is, but it's got that translucent, so it makes me kind of want to call it saran wrap or something, but of course it's not. But we're going to be doing the sandwich a little bit different to start out with, just because we want to kind of tape this in place. Now your splash sheet is a little bit larger, so we will be trimming it down a little bit. So, you know, don't panic about this or anything, but I'm just going to show you a different little way to kind of sandwich these guys. I'm going to start with trimming my foil, and I want it big enough that it's going to fit my glimmer plate. But normally how we would put the glimmer plate straight onto the platform, normally we lay this down, we put the foil face down, and then your cardstock, right? So I'm just going to build that same exact sandwich, just upside down. So I'm going to put my cardstock, my foil face up. Did you guys see how I laid it down when I cut it? And then I'm going to put my glimmer plate. I'm going to take some cool tape. This is a little bit heavier tape than washi tape, but still removable. And I'm going to put it at the very top of my glimmer plate. You guys see that? I have my foil kind of tucked under, but now I have the opportunity to kind of lift up my plate a little bit. Maybe tuck in my foil a little bit more, take off a little bit of this extra foil, save that little scrap for another project. And then I'm gonna put one more piece of tape just to kind of hold this bottom foil and plate in place so it doesn't, you know, just flap around. Because really what I'm doing, and you guys, did you see that I put my plate face down? What I'm gonna really do is pick up this whole thing and reverse it and put it on my platform so I can hit my timer now. And now my plate, you know, if I can imagine doing it backwards, is all in the proper order. You guys can definitely go back and rewind this video and kind of, you know, double check yourself, make sure you're all good. Because I'm using this foil as a resist, I want to put a double layer of foil so I get that really, really nice resist. That's why I'm going to this extra effort. And it could very well be that this single run through would be enough, but when I'm doing this watercolor technique, I just want to just really put a nice layer of foil. Now we can flip it over. I'm going to leave this top piece, you know, the longer piece that I did, but I can let this loosen this piece right here. I'll probably just take this piece off. Now I'm just going to flip my glimmer plate up, leaving it in place though. Don't take it off. Kind of flip it on its little hinge there. And now if I tilt this a little bit, I think you can see the reveal. But in order to have that really good resist, like I said, I'm going to put another layer of foil because I've kept this tape in place. It'll just flip right back down. It'll be really cool. You might be able to get by without doing this step, you know, of doing the extra tape, but I just don't want it to flop. All right, back to our machine and repeat. We have our second layer, and I guess it's going to just peel right up. There we go. Now we have our double layer of foil. Excellent. Maybe you can even see it a little bit more with that second layer. I think you can. Cool. All right, so we're going to stop our foiling for a minute. I'm going to just let my machine hang out there. We're going to add the watercolor to this piece because we want this to dry for a few minutes while we work on foiling the other bee and all the little wings and all that good stuff. So for my watercolor, and you can definitely use whatever products you have, but I grabbed the Jane's Mermaid markers and three colors in particular. They're listed on your postcard too, but I've got Beach, I think this is Starfish, and Pirate's Gold. Now I'm just going to grab a little clear block. Sometimes I use these for my little palettes, but any kind of surface you have. And I also have a water brush that just has plain water in it. The mermaid markers are super intense, and for this look, I kind of wanted a little bit softer, dreamier type effect. So I'm going to start out with a lighter color, which is the beach. Kind of the paler yellow. Be like a little sunshine here. And I'm putting it onto my clear block so then I can add a little bit of water and dilute it even more. Even though that's pretty pale as we go, but add a little bit of water. And when you add your watercolor to this, you'll definitely see the resist going on. But you also want to just keep your watercolor kind of loose, kind of free. You know, don't try to stay inside the lines. Just have fun with it. I want to add my other colors in between, but this can kind of saturate my splash sheet here, my water sheet, and kind of let it start grabbing some of that water and soaking in. Now we start adding a little bit more intense color. You can see that this has got a little bit more gold going on. It's pretty, pretty, pretty. Moving that color around. And then because I thought it was fun, I just wanted to add a little splash of pink in there. Your pink is also going to kind of blend with your yellows here and create a slight orange. Check out how I'm kind of really watering down my pink because it's really bright. And this will definitely dry a little bit lighter. You can blot it a little bit, and we will be blotting it afterwards to kind of get that resist effect in. See how the peach and the yellow and the pink kind of make a peachy color. Love that. Water down my pink a little bit more. It's fun how every time you do it, it comes out a little bit different. Okay, now I'm taking my tissue and I'm just going to kind of come in and kind of blot. I want to kind of get where that foil is so it shows the resist really well. Isn't that an interesting way to use the foil? I just love it. So I'm really happy with that. What do you guys think? Do you love it? So fun. What a great technique. I'm anxious to try that on some other foil plates and just really go to town with that opal foil. Okay, so we're going to let this dry and then we're going to come back and start foiling that bee. So we've got our watercolor piece drying. We're going to get back to foiling the other elements of our card. We've got our little bee here. And we're actually going to foil her twice. So I'm going to start with that and then I'll move on to the sentiment and we can do the little die cutting. So you should have a panel of whipped cream cardstock, and we're going to kind of just foil one bee here and one bee here. It's not going to be a big deal. I think you'll have plenty of room. We'll get her on the glimmer platform. I'm putting her a little bit higher on my platform just so when I put my cardstock there, I'll leave room for the other little cute bee. And I can cut one strip of foil here and cut it in half. So we're doing an extra bee because all we're going to do is cut out that little wing area with the matching die, and then that's going to give us a little extra dimension for our bee. So I think it'll be so cute. Again, positioning my cardstock so it's a little bit lower. Oh, and we can't forget the little crown. We've got to glimmer that little guy too. I might do both of those together next. Back to our same normal glimmering routine here. First little bead, I'm going to bring the crown in. See if I lay my paper down there, that'll go there and that there. Got to make sure I get my paper the right direction, right? Didn't overlap my two images. I'm glad about that. I'm going to put my sentiment there to heat up while we reveal this guy. I think I'll do my sentiment before we do the die cutting. But there, Perfect. There are two little bees. One will die cut with a normal die. Maybe I'll tape that on while that's heating up. I'll get a double duty here. Get it all ready to go. The little crown doesn't have a die, but for our card project, I just fussy cut that. So since I'll be fussy cutting it. All right, we've got our sentiment going on here. And you could definitely use the other sentiment if you want. I'm just switching it up. So fun. And we'll trim that a little bit narrower, but I set it aside for now. Now, like I said, we'll do our little bit of die cutting here. So our little bee's ready to go. Alrighty. And our glimmering is all done for this card. I'm going to start with my card base and work my way into finishing this little guy up. Now you've got a pink mat in your card kit. And obviously this guy is too big to fit on that mat. So here's where the trimming this mat comes in. Just grab my little trimmer. I'm going to start just by trimming a little bit closer to the little honeycomb. Just so I don't get it too crazily not centered. I'm looking for about 3 3/4 wide here. It can be a little bit bigger than that, but let's test out the width here with our mat. Yeah, I think that's pretty good. 3 3/4. So 5 inches high, and just kind of center your honeycomb about 3 3/4 inches wide. Now my panel's dry, it feels good. If yours is not quite dry, don't adhere it until it's good and dry. But if yours is dry, then you are ready to go. I'm gonna use a little bit more adhesive than maybe I normally would, just so it lays nice and flat. That also helps this, you know, if you have any kind of lumpiness or anything, it helps keep that panel flat. Mine's pretty flat, so I'm pretty happy with that. Okay, so before you actually add it to your card front, though, we're going to add a little bit of ribbon. So we have one long length of our banana stitch ribbon, which has this darling little stitched edge, by the way. So I want to cut off just enough to, at first, wrap around my card base. I'm going to kind of position it so, you know, maybe just overlaps my honeycomb just a little bit there. Again, then I'll kind of hold it and make sure it's straight. This is just going to tuck under, and then we're going to be adding a more fluffy bow on top. So at this point, you can go ahead and add your adhesive. I am going to use foam squares, but you can use, you know, regular adhesive and just keep it flat. Totally up to you. I'm going to help hold my ribbon down like we did in our other card. All right, so that's just going to go on our card base. And the remainder of the ribbon, you can either tie a single bow, or you can do what I'm going to do and tie a double bow. Just kind of by kind of doing a figure eight with your fingers here. And then you slide it through the loop and tuck it in again. But it creates a nice little double bow. We've got a little bow. We're going to add our little bee elements, our flower, which I'm going to trim this wire also. Okay, and one more element we haven't talked about so far is this little pin element that's in your kit also. That kind of got left in my Ziploc there. One of our little fashion pearls here. So this little pin is going to be kind of fun to kind of prop our butterfly up. I think I'm going to start with a placement of that. And kind of watch how I do this. It's a little bit of engineering. It's almost like building it backwards. But I want to get everything in the right place. So I'm starting with my bee, and my bee is actually going to be attached to this little clip. So instead of putting the clip first and then trying to figure the bee out, I just like to do this. So I've got the foam square back here. And now I can kind of tuck my pin in, which is going to go behind my bow. But now I can kind of look and decide, you know, where I want the little bee angled or what direction she's going to be. And then once I get her in place, because she really is my focal point, I want her to be in the perfect spot, then I can decide, okay, where do I need to have my bow to cover up the pin? Does that make sense? So that's why I do it that way. Another little card making tip. I'm actually going to put 2 dots on this one to make sure it stays in place. And of course you can use, you know, glue or hot glue or whatever you want there. There's our fluffy little bow, so cute, and we're going to add the flower in a minute. But let's work on the bee and our little sentiment first. I'm going to grab a couple little foam squares for these wings. And I'll show you one more little tip I'm going to do too. And this is optional. You guys don't have to worry about this so much, but I did put a little tiny bit of glue at the base of each wing. Just like a little dot. And then when I foam square the little extra layer of wing, I'm going to tilt it a tiny bit. Just kind of press that center section down. It dries quite fast, but you may have to hold it there. Maybe even want to put your little clear block or tape runner or something on there. I think it just makes it a little more dimensional. I'll kind of turn the card to the side a little bit. So see how that little foam square is going to pop under there? And just make that a little bit more poppy. So again, if you don't want to do that, it's perfectly fine. If you like the little bit of glue there, go for it. All right, so you also want a little foam square for the crown. Because she's got to be the queen bee, right? And I kind of just tucked the crown a little bit behind her antenna. So she's popping out like that. Oh my gosh, so cute. Just love it. Now my sentiment, I'm going to trim a little bit skinnier and place it right across the top. I don't know why. I felt like mine needed to be extra skinny across the top. I don't know why. I'm going to trim a little banner shape at this one end. And then check my length. We made this cardstock a little bit wide for you, so you can have room to do your adjustments. Looks like I'll trim it right about here. And again, because we can, we're going to pop it up. You're almost done with card number three, guys. Great job with all your glimmering. Right, I've got my flower. We'll bring in more glue dots. If your flower's a little bit smushed, you can fluff it out a little bit. I love that the peachiness kind of picks up our watercolor and, of course, the card base. And last but not least, got a few of our little gold dots. Again, these are just sweet little accents. You can kind of put them wherever you'd like. There we go. We've got our Just Because / Oh Honey card. Whichever sentiment you use, I know it's absolutely adorable. I love how that turned out, and I love the opal foil back there giving us that nice resist. Super cute and adorable. Go ahead and leave this card up for just a second so you can catch up if you need to. And we're in the home stretch. We'll be right back for project number four. And that brings us to project number four. Oh my gosh, we're almost done. But we would not want to neglect this sweet little cardlet, which is called Lovely Ladybug. We haven't used this one yet. So we've got our really cool little background. Almost looks like little leaves or something. I love it. Ladybug, and of course her wings. These are super cute. They're a little bit separate, so we're going to do two different colors. I think that'll be fun. Then we'll want to die cut those, of course, the matching dies. And let's see if I can pick the right sentiment. Of course you can use either one. I'm going to use the Hello Lovely Lady for this card. And of course you've got your postcard, again with the instructions on it and the photo. You can follow along. I think that'll be good. Maybe we'll start with the biggest one first. So I'll kind of scooch these guys. This, of course, is your last kit. So I guess I figured you guys knew which kit we're working with now. I'll line this up on the platform and put the timer on. Now, the first thing we're going to foil is this little background oval. So you want to take this oval die cut that's already been cut for you, of course. I'm going to use a little bit of gold foil. Now, I realize there's too much surface area here. If I kind of hold the oval up, you'll see that, you know, we've got more foil, so hopefully we won't waste too much foil, but I'm going to put my strip down the middle there. You notice I haven't put my oval on yet because I'm going to kind of wait till I get my platform a little bit closer, ready to go. Now when I put it on, I think I'll have a little bit better chance of getting it, you know, somewhat straight. It doesn't really matter, but you want your leaves to be, you know, somewhat straight on that oval. All right, I can see that it popped off there. That's good. And there we go. I'm going to set that aside. You can see that I have a little bit of extra foil on my plate. That's totally fine. You can take a little bit of undo if you want to scrape that off, or just leave it. It totally does not affect the performance. Okay, so now we're going to do some wings. We're going to do our little ladybug body. All right, you've got two different color cardstocks now, but you want to do the ladybug wings with the darker pink, and you want to do the ladybug body with the lighter pink. They're both using gold foil, so trim that up. I'll put my timer going while I'm waiting. Might even move this down just a smidge. So my wings are going to be the darker pink, and my little ladybug body is going to be the lighter pink. Now, as soon as that light goes solid, I'll run it through. Of course, once we've got these done, we're going to foil our little sentiment. There's our wings. So cute. This has got to be the cutest little ladybug ever. All right, so the sentiment, we might as well foil that while we're at it, and then we'll go back and do our die cutting. Hello, lovely lady is what I chose. I just need a little strip of foil. Isn't it fun that you guys got a whole roll in your kit? You'll be able to do so many more projects. And again, this strip is wider and bigger than you need, so don't stress too much about getting it lined up. Just run that guy right through our machine. And like I said, I'll trim this down in a minute. We've got our ladybug and our wings. We want to cut both of those out. And again, a reminder not to put your tape over your little foiled critter. I think this is the last of our die cutting, too. Bring in some of the other pieces to our card kit here. I love how Karina and her team does such a great job kitting these for you. She's always back there busy as a bee, or busy as a ladybug, I don't know which. Okay, I'm gonna use foam squares to pop this up. This oval will go right in the middle of your Pico Petite oval. And then again, this might not have shown up on the photo so much, but you've got this really cool little embossed piece. So it's got this fun little mini or tiny dot embossing on it. That's from our tiny dot embossing folder. That's one of the Fun Stamper Journey products. Super cute. You're just gonna layer it right up with this buttercream matte. I think this is about 4 1/4 inches square once it's all said and done. And this little cutie is gonna come together really quick now that we have the foiling done. All right, love how that's popped up. I don't think we need to pop this guy up. We'll just kind of get it on right in the center there. And then this is really all gonna be about the ladybug being the star of the show here. I'm gonna let her hang out kind of on the edge of this fun little die. And then again, I'm gonna cut one of my squares kind of diagonal. So I have two little sort of pointy pieces and they should fit perfectly on the back of these wings. So good way to get mileage out of your foam squares, right? You could also just take your finger and just gently kind of bend these wings just a smidge. This is great little kind of pearly cardstock. It's gonna give a little dimension to those wings. You could even kind of dip it in the middle just a bit. Again, kind of molding as you go along. I think I can just trim this one by hand. You kind of want this one pretty skinny, so trim away. And I like to put a little banner on either side of this because it's going centered on that die cut. So I'm gonna do a little banner cut on both ends. Just makes it seem like a little flag or something, right? I'm actually gonna bring in my wet glue for this because I wanna, two reasons. One, I wanna make sure it gets centered. So I'm gonna have a little extra second to move it around. And also because it is so skinny. I can kind of put this right across my oval. And again, taking that extra second to kind of position it, make sure it's straight. Okay, so now you have some pearls in your pack. You can just kind of put these little guys wherever you want. Maybe a pair here, maybe two down here. I don't know. Whatever looks cute to you. All right, one more. Somehow I like to have an odd number. You guys like that? All right, and guess what, guys? Really, that is all there is to this sweet little card. I think the two-tone ladybug makes it so darling. Then you've got the little Pico Petite oval back there and all the glimmering layers. So fun. So I'm gonna bring in the other three cards we finished because who doesn't want to look at all their darling things they finished? There's my Oh Honey and Just Because that I traded, kind of swapped the sentiments. That's okay. And there's our cute little swan with its big fluffy bow. Oh my gosh, Becca really knocked it out of the park with this collection. I know that you'll love all of her sweet cardlets. There's even a gorgeous sentiment that I didn't show you here today that also goes with the collection, so you'll definitely want to check those out on the website. And definitely check out all of Becca's fun things. So, as you saw this website pop up on the screen there, spellbinderspaperarts.com, I hope that you've enjoyed this sweet cardlets project tutorial. I have very much enjoyed crafting with you. And as always, I know that you will enjoy bringing paper to life.